What's up, everybody? Dirty Frank here, and we have a plethora of news from the Halloween world. And let me turn my TV off because I just noticed it is giving me a really bad glare in my glasses. Yes, Dirty Frank's wearing glasses. He wears contacts most of the time. Sorry about that. But so we have a plethora of news coming out of the Halloween world. They have finished filming. They are done. Everybody's done. It's been done for like a week, maybe even. Yeah, it's been about over a week, right? I mean, even 2 weeks. But we have things that came out on Halloween from Jamie Lee Curtis. We have pictures that are the dropping left and right here. And I just figured we're maybe going to touch on some things before. I know some people have already talked about it. I know I'm a little late to the game. I'm a little behind here. But I just wanted to talk a little bit about this. So sit back, relax, strap it down. Here we go. All right, Dirty Frank, and here we go. Let's just hit this hard and fast and hard and fast and harder and faster. And let's just say I just wasted too much time with that. But let's just go for this. We have a somewhat wrap on Halloween Kills. It's in production. It's production. It's in the post-production. They're going to get everything going. Here we go. Here is some things I want to talk about. We have a video. Watch the video before you watch this video, please. Because I'm going to talk about really some quick things. I want to get them off my chest. As I just lost something. Doesn't matter. Because here's the first thing I want to get off my chest is there's a picture or there's a video with a picture of Michael possibly getting out. He's got something in his, which looks at his right hand because his left hand has the missing digits. So in his right hand, it looks like possibly a sledgehammer or an axe. We also have a widened view of that showing us possible streams of water coming in, which would indicate the fire department has already made it there and possibly helped him out. And some people have speculated that it is an axe in his hand and the fire department came down to save him. From what we saw in Halloween 2018, there's no fucking way. There's no fucking way. It's just not possible that fire department got to that location in the middle of fucking nowhere that fast to save Michael Myers and that house still be still standing the way it was and have him come out almost untouched. I am going to have to suspend disbelief by a million times, and I don't know if I can do it this time. So if this is the way they're going to write this, it's fucking lazy writing. I want to get that out of the way, and it's over with. Next thing we know Tommy Doyle, Lindsay Wallace, Maren Chambers are in the same photograph together. Wanted to speculate a little bit on this real fast. I don't want this to be any longer than 5 minutes. But I don't see a scenario where we can fit into a 90-minute to 120-minute movie where these fucking three would be in the same fucking place together without having too much backstory. Speaking of backstory, we're going to transition right into this bullshit. Lonnie Elam looks like he has an encounter with Michael Myers and might have a role in this movie. That's another one we're adding to it. And I haven't even talked about Sheriff Brackett yet, who has not been seen since that picture of him in his fucking ridiculous uniform. Which, if he's still part of this fucking force, there's something wrong with this police force. And this is way more Southern Illinois than I expected it to be. But Lonnie Elam, father of Cameron Elam, somehow affected by Michael, OG Michael, in 1978. Sorry, getting a little worked up. Need to clear my throat with a little Tito's and ginger ale. Lonnie fucking Ingram. Thinking about fantasy football. Elam. I'm thinking about Mark Ingram. Sorry. Who's my... one of my fantasy running backs. He's my flex this week, I think, so. As long as David Johnson's back, so. Doug Johnson, no. Anyways. Let's go back. So, Lonnie Elam. is fucking back. And he has a role in this movie. Like, we don't need any more fucking sob stories about Michael Myers. He killed fucking four people on Halloween night in 1978, and he fucking killed a fifth if he counts when he killed his sister. We had five people die. And no, in 2018, we had more people die. But how many of those people died because of just pure... 2018, I still think the sheriff has something to do with this whole thing happening. And it went wrong. There was some kind of money exchange between... I still think there's something deeper in why Michael escaped. We know it was Sartain, but why maybe Sartain was going on the hunt with fucking Coach Yost. Who knows what his fucking name was in that movie? I will never remember him from the Halloween movie besides getting his fucking head smashed at the end. Which pisses me off. Because he's a fucking good actor, and I would like to have him in the next movie. It would have been nice to have him as the fucking sheriff. I think he's sheriff material. It seems like he spent a lot of time. But maybe we get to see his younger self. Apprehend Michael. So apparently he was there when he was the one. He talked about how he was the one that did whatever. But I don't want to see Michael Myers in cuffs either. So don't show me that. There's a picture out there of Michael Myers maskless as 1978. Looks like he's like clean cut and shit. We'll see that how that works for the fucking fans. You guys did not build a fandom yet. You just kept the loyalists at bay with your last movie. Do not go fuck it up like Rob Zombie did. I mean, he fucked it up in the beginning of it, but he kept some loyalists around to stick around and say, hey, I'll see what he has for the second act of this, and don't do what he fucking did. Please. I just beg you. Just because you got a couple good ratings on fucking Rotten Tomatoes, don't think you can now make it your own fucking movie, because you can't. You need to keep the simple stupid. And if you get fucking out of control, you're still probably going to make money. But it might suck. So anyways, that's what Dirty Frank gets to say. I'm under 7 minutes. Here we go. You guys, subscribe to me, please. Please, please, please. Or follow me on Instagram at RiotAct1156. That's RIOTACT 1156. I encourage you all to please comment below and let me know what I do well. Dirty Frank has been drinking heavily throughout this whole video and before this video. I love all you guys. Take care. Have a good night. It's a Wednesday night. There's a basketball game on, but somebody's sitting for time management. So here we go. Look at Michael Jordan. I think he played 82 games every single year. Besides that season where he broke his foot, and maybe a couple later seasons. But yeah, go fuck with that one. All right, anyways, good night. Goodbye. See you later.
Dirty Frank Dahmer, he's a gourmet cookie. I got a recipe for any single soupy. Wanted a pass, so she relaxed. Now the little groupie's getting chopped up in a bag. I got a cup full of fleshy fresh ingredients. American Berlin, this ain't that quite expedient. Eats meat, a release. Bus driving taller on your head than on your feet. Dirty Frank. Dirty Frank, girl. A Dirty Frank.